Hello everyone, I'm your tutor Simar, and once again welcome to the sessions of Illustrator. So today is the third session of our series of Illustrator, or I should say graphic designing. Till now we have just seen the introduction to the software we were using and everything we needed to know to get ourselves started. And this leads me to start for the most important set of tools. Starting off with if you have used MS Paint in your life, you must be knowing how we used to draw so many favorite things with pencils or brushes and then fill them with a color to add life to it. Some unnecessary lines and strokes were there, we erased them. Like we knew how to add and remove things on a canvas and which tools were required for that. Similarly, in Illustrator, we are given with a bunch of tools which we are going to use to show our creativity. And most often, more than that. See, rather the fact there are so many tools in here, as you can see, but there is still a separate group of tools called primary and secondary. What's that came from, you might be wondering. The thing is, the primary tools are those which are, no matter what you are creating, they are going to be utilized by you, and no other tool can help you to do the task as the other way they perform. For example, tools like selection tools or direct selection tools, hand tool or magnifier tool. These tools are quite essential for every task or project we work on, while every other tool left are sort of non-identical and can be used depending on the type of work we do. Like, we don't use gradient in every design, we don't use 3D and perspection in every design. Like, such tools are required only to perform specific tasks only, but not every time. You got my point? So let's start with the very first tool or primary tool, which is a selection tool. So first of all, let's create a new file first, and to do that just go to file, here we go, select new, or there you can just open a new file by pressing Ctrl plus N together as a shortcut for a new file, the way you like it. After that, this window of preferences selection of your artboard open up. Choose your preferences as per your requirement. First, I think let's give it a name to our file, and let's give it anything like selection or anything really. Give your artboard the dimensions. Keep it to square this time, and let the color mode be same and rest of the settings on default. Now press create and let it open. So this is your square workspace again. Leave all things apart. The color mode and workspace as today's session is only specifically for the tool that is a selection tool. And to select the selection tool, drag your mouse wheel over the toolbox over here and select the very first tool on top left side of the toolbox. You see that? The identity of selection tool is that it is a hollow pointed arrow. Select this tool, and the moment you press left click on it, the cursor will change something into this. You see? Our cursor has turned into a pointer black arrow. Thus show the selection tool is selected at this moment. So this is our selection tool, but what does it do? Why is it for? Well, quite significantly, according to its name, it is used to select items on artboard and let us perform transformation or movement or other things on the selected item. When you click on any item that selected by this tool, it will be highlighted with a very thin rectangle surrounding to its boundary, which tells about the selected item. For instance, let's take an example for that. I will make a rectangle on my artboard and select it with the selection tool. Now let's just draw a rectangle with the help of a rectangle tool. For that, just come over here and find a tool which is shaped as a rectangle. Like it is over here, some columns down. Or if you want to use keyboard to select that tool, press M on your keyboard and the rectangle tool will be selected. Our cursor will change. Before it was dark arrow, which is now a crosshair, thus indicated the rectangle tool is selected. Okay, so I'm going to drag it now on the artboard to create the shape. Here is a basic shape and it is just outline of a rectangle, has no color is filled in it. The reason for that is that our fill is off right now. Fill is actually a term in Illustrator to fill the color of any shape, like a solid we call it as. And the stroke is on right now. That's why only rectangle's outline is visible. Still, the fill and stroke term I will explain further later, but still that thing apart. So here is a rectangle. And the moment you draw a rectangle or any shape on board, a very thin blue line is surrounded, like the shape we select with some small square at the center of each side of the shape, as you can see. In our case, the rectangle is covered with a blue line exactly at those points where boundary resides. And those small square are also visible, which I will explain later. This blue box indicated that you selected a shape with a selection tool. And to come out of that selection tool, click anywhere outside the shape and your shape will get deselected. You see, whenever the item is selected, it will always be highlighted with a blue boundary and those small boxes on each edge and sides. These squares are called as transformation points. Well, the purpose of this square is to resize or stretch the shape in any direction. Like in here, let's try to change this shape. First, select the selection tool. Click on the shape. Here we go. When you hover your mouse cursor over any transformation point, it changes into very small two-sided black arrow. Click and draw over any transformation point and you can see a highlighted off resized or stretched shape. You see these floating identical shapes like I here do. Like whenever I try to click and drag on any such point, Illustrator gives us a real-time image of shape until we unclick our mouse on anywhere. You see? The benefit of this real-time projection is that it temporarily gives an estimation what type of shape we will get after we leave the mouse click. Pretty cool. This feature was not in previous version of Illustrator and still you can disable it, but though I can never suggest you to do something like that, like never. So in here I have a rectangle. And let's just try to turn this shape into a square just by pulling the transformation points. So I will just hold this side of my shape and try to stretch it out. The size of the sides is increasing as you can see. And let's try to stretch it a little more. Yeah. This is our shape. This is still not the exact square as there is a difference between two consecutive sides, but you got my point to explain the use of selection tool. Like this square is only made by a rectangle and stretching it in, I should say. Similarly, if I take any random shape that is not a polygon but a curved loop, here I will use a brush tool. just for example and draw a very weird shape. Let me select my brush tool. Here it is, like literally a weird shape. It doesn't have any meaning. Not so aesthetic, right? So here is the shape. Again, let's select the selection tool and click on this loop. The time I select it, as I said, our shape will get surrounded by a blue highlighted rectangle. This is what I was trying to explain about the highlight of selection. Coming back to our previous shape, let's just try to make a proper square. For that, again select the rectangle tool or on keyboard press M, and this time don't just drag your mouse after selecting the tool. You can press shift and then click and drag your mouse. You will see you are drawing a perfect square with all sides equal. To draw any particular shape exactly in same proportion or size, you press shift together with them. Like this is your square now. You can resize it by selecting the selection tool again. And while pressing the shift, click on any transformation point and drag. Yeah, this is what I meant. You will always get a consistent ratio of shape with the help of shift. Okay. There is one more thing, as you can notice in here. Whenever I try to select any shape, like in here, if I try to select this square, I can see small circles inside the selection highlights at each corner. These are called as corner widgets and are used to turn any angled corner into a curve. Like in here, if I show you, if I click and drag any of this corner widget, the vertices of my shape tend to transform like into a rounded shape rather than a pointed one. As per your need, you can use this technique to make many creative shapes, and also it is one of my favorite thing of Illustrator that I very much like. Like I have created so many patterns, beautiful patterns, just with this technique, and let us see something more like that in future. Like if I drag those corner widget into the center, you can actually see this square turned into a circle, like now with no edges and vertices. You can experiment your own things with various shapes to create something new every time. Like there's no limit to creativity. And yes, one more thing about the corner widget is that if I click and drag my mouse on these circles, here it go, and during that time I press keyboard arrow key up or down. I repeat, up and down key of my keyboard, you will see very interesting thing happening here. When I press up or down, the curves of the shape tend to bend inwards and outwards, and also straight line too. You see, when I press up, the circle turned into a rhombus and also to inside curved pattern. With this technique, you can create some shapes which are quite tricky and difficult to make normally. Selection tool is also used to cut or delete, copy the selected object. Suppose we have a shape over here. Let's make a square box over here. I will delete everything and select the rectangle tool. Here is our rectangle tool, and I will draw a very small square on my artboard with this. Remember, as I told, if you want to create proportional object, press shift and then drag and draw. So by pressing shift with rectangle tool, I will create this small square. Here is a square. So now I will try to copy this small square, and to do that, I will first select my shape with the selection tool. Then I will hit Control C together on my keyboard. This will copy my selected object.
To paste that object now, simply press Ctrl V, Ctrl plus V on your keyboard, and you can see your duplicate image on artboard. I pressed Ctrl V once, so the copied image got duplicated only with one copy. Now if I try to press Ctrl V again or multiple times, it will give me that much copies, like how many times I press the Ctrl plus V button. You see? Anyways, if you want to cut any object, copy pasting is that term we used to do in MS Word and all, or to move objects and copy things. If you want to cut any object, just press Ctrl X on your selected item and paste it again by pressing Ctrl plus V, like I told you earlier. And one important thing is, whenever you add a new object by copy pasting, the new object is added on the very top of the artboard. You see, this works as a sublayer of a particular layer, but each object can be edited if selected on a single layer itself only. You might not be getting what I'm trying to say. I will explain that to you in my further classes. So these were the basic of some selection tools. Now let's make something nice by using only a selection tool and some couple of tools I have teach you before. Like, I have a square over here. I will fill it with the color black. I will teach you how to do that in a later session. Just for example, I am showing you how selection tool can be useful to you. So I will select black color of the shape by selecting it. Now copy this by pressing Ctrl plus C, or either there is one more interesting and very quick way to copy and paste object with a selection tool. To do that, select any item. Like, I have selected this square. Next, you have to do is just to press and hold Alt on your keyboard and click on the object and drag your mouse anywhere. There you go. Now you can see that the copied object is floating along with the mouse cursor. Once you release the click anywhere on artboard or outside the artboard, the copied object will be pasted there. Okay. One thing has to be in mind that you don't have to release Alt until you drop your object. If you release your Alt button on your keyboard before the object, it will move instead of just duplicating. Okay, so you just need to keep this thing in mind. If you want to copy the things without copy pasting, you just need to press Alt and mouse click and try to drag it with a click. Okay. So now I will copy again the square, press and hold Alt again and drag it by clicking mouse left. One more thing. After you do that, like you press Alt and drag your object, you can also press Shift to move those objects in a straight path, vertically or diagonally or even horizontally also, thus giving you accuracy of straight paths. Similarly, if I select and by holding Alt on my square, I will try to keep it on the exact right side of any gap in between. Let's just join the edges. Perfect. Once you do that, again copy this box the same way we copied this box. Let's do it. Copy it by Ctrl and C, or by pressing Alt and mouse left and dragging, pressing Shift to keep in same line, and place it again here. Now what if I want to do this step continuously? Like, I want to do this copy pasting 10 times or more than that. I can't do it again and again. Like, it will be quite time consuming for me. Either I can create one, then paste it next, and then again select both and copy paste them to create four such copying again, and so on. It's still a lot of work to do here. So there's a shortcut in Illustrator to avoid that repetitiveness. Like, if I delete these extra three squares, again, I will copy and drag by holding Alt, like I told you before, and place it in the same way as I did before. But instead of copying again, I will simply press Ctrl D on my keyboard. What does this do? Well, pressing Ctrl D just after you have copied anything, Ctrl C or just by dragging, it will automatically generate a copy of that box next to recent ones. I will press Ctrl D again and a new box appears. So what is actually happening here? By Ctrl D, the Illustrator reads and repeats the previous task, like an increment, I should say. It keeps on increasing, moving further with count and distance also. So it's a very great method, whether you want to draw a pattern or something which have repetitive shapes. So I will create 8 such shapes by pressing Ctrl and D together. And once I do that, I will select the whole column of 8 boxes and copy and paste it with the same technique we made as 8 boxes. Now, first of all, let's just create 8 such shapes. I will press it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. That's it. Yes. Now we'll create 8 rows, 8 such rows like that of 8 each rectangle or square, sorry. And again, let's do it. I will take selection tool here and select the whole column of 8. I will just drag. Yeah, here we go. All boxes are selected with the selection tool. By pressing Alt, not just pressing Alt, by pressing Alt and holding it and clicking and dragging by pressing Shift also, I will keep them just under these grids. I will just press Alt, hold it and drag it. There it is. Now it seems like a big black rectangle. Now the next thing I'm gonna do is, I will try to delete some alternate black squares from the grid. For example, I will delete this box by just pressing delete or backspace, but both works the same way, I guess. We'll delete another black square box to next to this box and we'll repeat that for one line. Let's just do it. Better. In this below black grid, I will delete this box, and same steps will delete the alternative and repeat it. This one, yeah. So this is the thing I was looking for. Now you must have got an idea what I'm trying to create. Yes, I'm trying to make a chessboard. A chessboard is a 8x8 grid with black and white alternative squares. So right here, I just made 2 grids of black and white. But to complete the full board, we need 6 more grids. And the steps are going to be the same for that. Remember how we started from a single square and created a full grid throughout? So here I will drag and select the whole shape. With a selection tool, I will select it. And same steps will be followed. I will select this whole grid, selection tool. Okay. Now I will press Alt and hold it and click it and drag it with a shift and place it just right under it. Here we go. Now, as you are familiar with these, next step is Ctrl D, as I told you before, to repeat the previous recent step. I will press Ctrl D one more time and one more time. Thus, This creates a full chessboard with all black and white square alternately placed. Pretty cool, isn't it? So you see how the selection tool and some shortcut help us to create this complex shape in just few steps. Let's draw something else with the selection tool.
Now let's draw, for that I will clear the screen. Take selection tool and select all this content and move it over here. And again, I will select my rectangle tool or press M on my keyboard. And I will try to draw some figures over on my artboard. I can stretch it to this like rectangle. Again. This is okay. Again, a little bit thinner, something like this. Let's just stretch it in that way. Oh, one more. That's better. Again, I will take the rectangle tool and make some very small windows, like of square size. Yes. Okay. I will select this with a selection tool. Click it and press the Alt button again and drag it by pressing Shift. Remember, my Alt button and Shift button are still pressed, like I'm holding on it. Once I leave it, the shape will get moved instead of duplicating. I will copy it or duplicate it and place it here like this. And now again I will select both the shapes together. I will take selection tool, press Shift and select this also. By holding Alt and Shift together, I am bringing them now. Got that? And by pressing Ctrl D together, you will get duplicate multiple items like this. Last one, I think we should avoid. Just press Ctrl plus Z, that will undo the thing. And again, if you want to make more windows in that, you can make that. Remember, to make the squares, I'm holding on my Shift button. Make it a bit smaller than the regular ones. Take rectangle tool, or I'll just copy this one only. Like this. That's okay. Select these three squares and again press Alt, hold Alt and Shift together and press Ctrl D, giving me multiple windows. I will just try to copy these with selection tool only. I dragged and selected the window. Not all the windows are required. I will deselect it and I will copy it by pressing Ctrl C and Ctrl V. I took them and placed it here. Okay. You can again duplicate them by just selecting them, holding Alt. Sorry. This deselect this bigger rectangle. I will select these again, deselect the bigger rectangle, and again Alt
and this. Here we go. Delete the extra squares which are overlapping my line. And again the same step. Select, copy or hold alt and paste. I think the bigger rectangle also gets selected. Let's do it again without selecting this. I already selected and copy and paste it over here by holding alt. I guess this time the windows are quite bigger than the required rectangle. I will press shift and decrease them now. So you see how I created this shape that is quite complicated to make, but just with copy paste and the selection tool and with the help of some shortcuts I was able to make that. Last building I think is left. Again I will just draw small squares, copy them by that, select them again. You see how I created this couple of buildings just with the help of a rectangle tool and selection. It seems quite incomplete, like there is no color in it, but it's okay to do it till now because we just need to know the basics. The complete image I think we will continue next further. Like the only thing I just wanted to explain you this tool and the things you can do with that, like copy pasting and movement, resizing, reshaping, like everything I told you. And I think that's quite enough for today. And just recall whatever we have gone through in this session, like to select selection tool, you need to press V on the keyboard, or so like I told before, to select rectangle, press M. The selection tool is used to copy, paste, or delete the things on your artboard by selecting it. Just you need to drag and select by pressing left click. And another thing was that how I use this selection tool to duplicate things in the easiest way we could, and the use of alt to duplicate and shift to sustain the movement in a straight path, and also some of the shortcuts that are quite essential for your beginning processes, like from beginner to intermediate as we go through. I think that's enough for today, I guess. And I will only request you to just practice this thing. These are like couple of small things that are going to be used in your future classes. And I will only say that just don't try to rush things too quickly. Like I just made this very basic uncolored shape, and we don't need to complicate things by just loading them. Now as you know these basic things, so I will just request you to try out with something new every time with each tool I make familiar you about. Okay, so that was a good class, and thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe this channel and press the bell icon, as more amazing content is coming on its way as we will move further. Till then, see you guys.